Everybody else good to go? All right, I call the Monday, January 14th, 2019, first meeting of the year into order and ask for a roll call, please.
Bobby Mock.
Here.
Catherine Whitman.
Here.
Jackie Thomas.
Here.
Kevin Kling.
Here.
Robin Dunlap.
Here.
Debbie Nasta.
Here.
Joe Baker.
Here, we have a quorum established, and ask everyone in the audience to please join us in the pledge allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic which stands one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, everybody, appreciate that. First on this evening would be public comments for items that are not on this evening's agenda. Anything to say for the evening that's not on the agenda?
Is that off that list, is it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, come on up.
Because I'm first on the list. My name's Kerry Jarvis, and I think the city has done a real injustice to the citizens of this city because of the fact that they've changed the trash service. In the past, when you would talk to the guys with the old trash service, two of the big trash cans, and it didn't cost you anything extra, or five of the 32-gallon trash cans. Now, what are we going to do with branches when we haven't even got to the season yet, whenever we get snow and everything breaking off all the branches? You're going to want them all cut up and put in the trash can before they'll pick them up? And I've seen that already, too, that, you know, they've had trash sitting out by the trash can, but if it's not in the trash can, they're not going to pick it up. They're not going to get out. And I'd just soon have employed a couple more people with the old trash company, and they were easy to work with. We could bundle branches, put them out there, they'd pick them up. It's just crazy. I've been here since 1972 in the city of Dacono, and the only time that we've ever had to move our trash cans to the street was like when the alleys were not accessible. And then when they did change, people came over here, some friends, and asked, well, why do we need to move our trash can to the street? Oh, well, you don't need to. Then we get another message, well, you got to put them out on the street. I would just as soon not have my trash cans out on the street. I think it looks better when they're not on the street. And I, you know, it's just crazy to me that we've got to pay for an extra trash can. You know, it costs more. I've got a neighbor that moved in their new house. They couldn't even find his house. They didn't have the correct address. He had two of the big roll around trash cans out there, and from all of his moving, they had all the trash there, but they wouldn't pick up any of it because it wasn't in their trash can. And finally, he had to call him again, and at expense of his, then basically he got him to come back out again, and they picked it up then. But it's just crazy to me that we're going backwards with this trash situation. That's basically what I've got to say.
Thank you. Appreciate that. Unfortunately, yeah, this our trash guy that we love retired. You know, I mean, that's. I wish Gator was back. I miss him terribly. I'd love to have that guy back.
Yeah.
What about the company that took over American?
Same
but
thing.
Funny. So American. I'll tell you what. So Paul's here. Paul works for Waste Connections.
How are you?
Yes.
How's it going?
I'm really happy that I'm able to hear your comments and bring them back and address them. So my name is Paul Breiterman. I'm with Waste Connections. I'm the sales manager here. Previously, you may have dealt with Jeff Stewart or Brandon Wazowski. Both are still with our company. They just have different roles. Jeff is now in St. Louis. I've been here since 2011. The company had sent me to Houston, Omaha, and now luckily they asked me to come back. So I'm real familiar with the area. I'm real happy to be back, and I'll be your point of contact. And I can totally, Kerry, is it?
Yes.
Kerry, I can totally understand your frustrations. It's a very difficult move for communities that have been the old style curbside take-all type service where you put it out, the rear load truck comes up, they put it in the back, they take everything and they drive off. The more modern way of doing it, which is what you have now, which is that automated side load. One of the biggest things Here's a great example. So we had talked about Gator, and Gator had sold their business to American. And American was an East Coast company out of Virginia, which we just acquired December 1st. Our number one priority is safety. If you look at our values, we don't just put it there as window dressing. We live it. We track how safe we are by what we call our incident rates. Now, an incident can be I hit your mailbox. An incident can be I hit your F-150. God forbid it be I hit your child or your house. They're all incidents. Okay. To give you an idea, American Disposal, which was primarily more of the rear load style trucks, those take-alls, they'd have helpers on the back of the trucks. They had an incident rate of 97. Now let me explain what 97 means. It means that out of every 100 employees, 97 of them will have an incident within the year. Can you believe that? Now that could be a sprained ankle. I jumped off the truck, turned my ankle. That's an incident. It's a workers' comp claim, anything like that. In the industry, Waste Connections of Colorado, we have a 9. So think about that for a moment. 97, and again, it could be them hurting their ankle, it could be them hurting your property or you or a loved one, but they had a 97. And primarily it was because of the old-fashioned way of doing things. You know, most communities, a lot of HOAs, a lot of municipalities go into these automated side load systems where this truck, it prevents those extra people having to get out, you know, hurl. It could be light most of the time, but we start talking about those trees and branches, those grass clippings. That's an 80-pound, 70-pound can. You do that, you know, repeatedly. It doesn't take much to throw out your back or something like that. So it is, when I was in Omaha, we switched the whole city of Bellevue, which was 15,000 homes. And they switched from a curbside take-all, 15,000 homes incorporated into an automated side load system. That was just last year. The city of Omaha, actually 150,000 households, is looking at doing the same exact thing, and they just went out to RFP as we literally are speaking. So it's becoming more and more popular because it's less wear, it's more safe, but it is frustrating, and I understand that. We do offer additional cans if the household does need additional cans, different sizes. I heard earlier we were talking about maybe some residents that don't have a lot of need for a lot of trash and space limitations. You can go smaller ones. We definitely want to work with you. But unfortunately, if stuff is outside of the can, we don't have the ability to throw it into the hopper the way that we did on that rear load truck, you know, where it's just put in the back. I'm going to give you my business card as well, Carrie. I want you to feel, and I'm going to leave them up here. So if anyone in the audience or council member would like a card, to email me directly. I know you have point of contact with Nadine or Joe or whoever it is you work with at our company, but always feel free. Hey, I had a resident come to me and they asked me this question. Don't hesitate to just, don't wait for a board meeting or a council meeting or anything like that. Just go ahead and shoot me an email and I'll get with your resident or I'll get with you to get back to them, okay? What I initially came here for was I just wanted to make sure, because I know when we first started service, there were some issues, especially with the recycling, as far as timeliness. When that was brought forward, we immediately identified what the situation was. It wasn't even what can we do to fix it, it's this is the problem, this is what we're doing, immediately made a change, and I hope that it has gotten better. Okay, what that issue was when we first started the city, we put it on a day routing. You know when you're really hungry and you go to a buffet and you grab all that food not realizing you can't eat as much as you just grabbed? I think it was that pretty much that type of situation. We had too many things on that day. Well, we scrubbed everything else. Dacono became the priority on that particular day. Everything else followed suit or moved to a different day. So it was a real simple fix. Outside of weather, mechanical, you know, acts of God, I would not foresee any recurring issues. And if so, please feel free, okay?
Nice.
Can I answer any other questions or anything? Carrie, please reach out to me if you need anything or any individual concerns. As a sales manager, again, I'm part of the management team. And if I need to put in an order request because you have one particular situation, you send me an email and it'll get done.
The last time they came through was supposed to be recycled. They came through so late, it looks like they just dumped both of them, recycle and trash.
Was that last week or the week before?
Last week.
I.
And it was after 6 p.m.
Okay. No, that may have been a mechanic. I don't, that should not be the norm. If that repeats, let me know.
I did have the manager of the other company, too.
Okay. Let me know. I will never hide from any of our customers or residents. Okay? Your trash service is something that should be invisible, and I understand it can be a very passionate thing if it doesn't go smoothly.
Wow.
Okay?
Thank you. Nice. Yeah, my comment would be that I definitely, I noticed the difference from just the last couple of times, and I, you know, was one of the persons that didn't read the memo, so I was one of the persons that put the trash in the old receptacles and then got the confusion where what was going to be picked up. And I mean, I understand, I'm a big boy, I made the mistake, read the thing and realized, and I just put the trash out the next week. I did have a bunch of people call me and, you know, rant rave at me, and I just thought it was kind of funny because I did the exact same thing that they did.
Right.
So I mean, we are in a hurry, our lives are going 1,000 miles per hour, but I did notice the last couple of times whatever has been done's a little bit better, or better from what I've seen so far in my neighborhood.
Good.
Where I live. And thank you for coming out and putting
Absolutely.
Yourself out there, obviously. Yeah, I'm sure you've opened yourself up for some it's a little bit of slapping around, but it sounds like you're used to it. Thick skin.
Yeah, nobody calls trash companies to say, hey, your guy was here on time, he picked everything up, he did a great job.
Exactly.
Typically, if I hear from anyone, it's because, hey, what happened, whatever. So,
no, thank you.
I never want to hear from anybody,
because
that means I'm doing a good job, and we're doing what we need to do.
Yeah.
But what I tell people, or municipalities or businesses, I can't wait till we fail you.
Nice.
Okay? Because that's when you'll see the difference. Because everyone or every business, whoever it is going to get missed, because there's going to be something that's going to create a situation once a year, whatever the case may be, you're going to get missed. Just work with me, and then you'll see why you're actually with us. That's pretty much what I like to preach, okay? So
thanks for putting yourself out there.
Absolutely. So I'll just keep these up here, or should I just
give them out?
Okay.
Give them out to everybody. Appreciate you coming out. And
you betcha.
Please make yourself vulnerable.
Right. You bet. Have a great one.
All right, you too. Take care. Thanks a lot. It was nice. All right. Any other comments we made on this evening's council without not on the agenda? Then we will move to the consent agenda, which are the minutes of 2010. Wow, it's been a whole month, guys. Nice time off. 2018 regular minutes. The accounts payable for $795,508.10. Resolution 1901 approving an intergovernmental agreement between the City of Dacono, Town of Frederick, Town of Firestone, Frederick Firestone Protection District, and Mountain View Fire Protection District, establishing an emergency management service area and emergency management coordinator, and for sharing associated costs. Resolution 1902 approving expenditures to Lawls in the amount of $33,135.81 for 7 convertible tablets, keyboards, and docking stations used for mobile dispatch terminal equipment. Resolution 1903, approving the application for convert temporary use permits for 137 shares of water dedicated to Autumn Valley Ranch, filing 338 and filing 423 Interstate Ford 15, Mountain Views Estates 1, Sweetgrass filing 6, number 60. To section 131 renewal, water contract with Northern Colorado Water Conservancy District, all in one breath. Resolution 1904, approving the amendment for the Appendix A to the contract with Kelly PC Legal Fees. Resolution 1905, approving the engagement agreement with Elizabeth how do I say her last name?
Piranos.
Yeah. Thank you, Piranos. Deloney Law Incorporated for outside counsel for oil and gas. Resolution 1906, approving expenditure in the amount of $13,700 to Lamp Ryerson for survey services. Tell the chief thanks for getting those docking stations. That's going to be really cool. Can't wait to see that, not see it, but hear the feedback on the field. So.
Yeah.
Council, these following items on the consent agenda are considered to be routine business matters by the council that can be decided without discussion and will be enacted with a single motion and a single vote. Any council member may request removal of any item they do not want to consider without discussion or wish to vote no. on without jeopardizing the approval of the other items on the consent agenda. Items removed will be placed under the general business category in order as they appear on the agenda. Council, what would you like to do with this consent agenda?
I move to approve the consent agenda as read.
Motion by Kevin, second by Kathy. Can we receive a vote, please?
Bobby?
Yes.
Catherine?
Yes.
Jackie?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
That all passes with all saying yes. Next is down the general business report and commission appointments. And I think Valerie's going to give us a presentation.
Well, I was hoping that we'd have as good a turnout this time as we did last time. We advertised the openings and we gave quite a long time to encourage people to apply. We did get some good applications and we have a list of the ones that were received and the people that the openings there are and the people that want to serve on the boards. We're still going to have some openings on the Liquor Authority and
some vacancies.
Yeah, some vacancies.
So only there's a way we could like pay them.
Well, by the way, the people, the openings and the people who would like to fill them have been turned in. On the Planning Commission, we received 3 applications. Right now, we currently have 2 regular seats open. Commissioner Member Owens has stated he is interested in filling a regular seat instead of an alternate. So if he is appointed to a regular seat, that leaves a regular seat and an alternate seat opening too. So it's up to council.
Cool.
Staff recommends.
Say that again, the alternate is separate from the 2 openings, correct?
Well, the alternate isn't open right now, but if Stan is moved into a regular seat,
it'll open up.
So.
What else?
That's all I have, unless you have questions.
Kev?
Yeah, I would like to see Stan get be a regular member. He does an outstanding job. Yes.
Yeah.
And I would also recommend that Jen be the alternate since she'd be the new person on there.
So how do we do this? Do we do a motion on each?
Just got one. You just got one.
Okay. Yeah, if you'd like to just do police advisory, liquor board, and then planning commission.
So one for each board.
Yes.
Okay, so if I
so what'd you say?
May be so bold, I will make a motion to appoint Stan Owens to a regular member seat, Derek Warden back to a regular member seat, and Genevieve Schneider as the alternate.
So moved.
Or second. Sorry. Yeah. You already said it once. I was like, just so moved. Right. It's moved forward, I believe, legally you can do that. So good to go. Motion by Kevin, second by Robin. Can we receive a vote, please?
Catherine?
Yes.
Jackie?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
Bobby?
Yes.
That motion passed with all saying yes. Kevin, you're running this train, so let's go.
All right. I'll make a motion for Police Advisory Committee to appoint Genevieve Schneider as a reappointment and Craig Elliott as a new appointment. And would they be... Neither of them are alternates, right, on that one. So it would just be regular members.
They meet every 15 years or so.
So I'll second that one.
Okay, motion by Kevin, second by Kathy. Can we receive a vote, please?
Jackie?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
Bobby?
Yes.
Catherine?
Yes.
That motion passes with all saying yes.
I move to reappoint Stan Owens to Liquor Authority.
Second.
Motion by Kevin, second by Robin. Can we receive a vote, please?
Kevin?
Yes.
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
Bobby?
Yes.
Catherine?
Yes.
Jackie?
Yes.
That motion passes with all saying yes.
All right. I move to reappoint Stan Owens to Board of Adjustment.
Second.
Motion by Kevin, second by Robin. Can we receive a vote, please?
Robin?
Yes.
Debbie?
Yes.
Bobby?
Yes.
Catherine?
Yes.
Jackie?
Yes.
Kevin?
Yes.
That motion passed with all saying yes. And for the record, since we do have audience members in here, it looked like this is a rubber stamp. We get these applications back in November and have enough time to kind of look at it. So this is kind of the finality of what's going on, knowing that these folks have been interviewed and some of them also have served before. So that's why you're not seeing an interview process now for when you do watch the video, as you're encouraged to do by folks. That's why you've seen this kind of go that fast. So. That being said, that concludes general business. We'll move to staff reports, and I believe we'll defer to AJ first.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. Wow, since we have plenty of time.
You want me to get the trash can back here?
No, we just had quite a bit built up from our meeting about a month ago. So I'll be publishing the 2019 calendar of events. You can stick on your refrigerator like I do, so you know what's coming up. The next one will be the Chamber of Commerce event for the Carver Valley. That's at Todd Creek Golf Course Clubhouse, and that's on March 2nd. So I'll be sending around that information if you would like to attend. At a February or March meeting, we'll have a presentation on the survey results. Hopefully some of you received and filled out the survey that we have. It's really interesting this year because it's our second year, so there's some data, you can see some trends.
Yeah.
And from seeing the draft report, we're trending in the right direction.
Yep.
It's really some positive information. So we'll have a presentation on that. Sam Mamet, if you know, he's the executive director for the Colorado Municipal League. He's retiring this year.
Really?
He really
is. Never thought they would go. Wow. So I Kevin Baumer slated to take it over?
You know, they're putting it out.
Okay. I won't keep that rumor dead then. I won't say anything.
But he, you know, he was, when I took my class for my master's degree before I became an intern here, he was a guest speaker, and I've always had a good relationship with him, and we've always said, hey, you need to come up to one of our meetings. So I actually got him on the schedule to be here February 11th.
Really?
To say hello to everybody.
Wow,
and and goodbye.
I'd like to see, Sam's a good guy.
He is. He's a really good guy.
That's awesome.
And then having an open house for him, and I'll, you know, if anyone wants to go down and see him out on March 21st. We have our economic development video that I will forward the links to. It works better when you download it or if you have a fast internet connection, so I'll send that out. Mayor
turned out good?
In that shoot. Yeah, it turned
That's
out
good.
Really well. It's kind of a short video we can use to promote, you know, our business.
Nice of Earthroamer to let us use this spot. That was really fun.
Yeah,
appreciate
Earthroamer,
you know.
Other
it's nice that they were generous with their time and their space.
Yeah, it was really good. So as far as construction, the they're going to move quick. CDOT, as you know, is widening the intersection at State Highway 52 in Colorado. They're going to start mobilizing at the end of this month, and they want to wrap up in August. So there's going to be some headaches going through the intersection.
Okay.
I'll have to shut parts of it down. But when it's all done, it'll be wider. It'll be a much better experience.
Super cool.
And then CDOT also approved Frederick to go ahead and advertise for the acceleration lane that comes off the ramp.
Yeah, eastbound.
Yeah, eastbound. Yeah. It's right there in front of Burger King and where Maverick will go.
Nice.
I know I've been hit twice there in my career here.
Yep.
Just people, you want to, you know, look for traffic this way.
They're still going.
And then you'll hit someone that they're stopped. So, very much needed project. So they're just advertising for that, but it's not incredibly complex. So it should be wrapped up fall.
Colorado comes with cone zones, so we should be, everyone in the state should be used to that. So.
Yeah. And if you're going north of here, they're starting to do work on the expansion on 25. So they have shutdowns from time to time. Everything that you've seen from on the south part, so they're continuing that. As you also know, I think I sent around, St. Vrain Valley School District has a board seat vacancy. So anyone would know anyone that wants to apply, would like to apply, feel free. I know that's one of the priorities to improve relations with the school district. To that end, I've set up a meeting next month with the superintendent.
No.
And I know the superintendent is having a mayor's meeting with the regional mayors, but you know, we can kind of jumpstart our what we talked about at the works planning session to kind of.
Yeah, I think the planning session was kind of heads going north and south with just rekindling that flame, and I'm sure it can be done. I've been in contact with Don Haddad, and. Unofficially with some hellos and stuff like that, and he's definitely open and receptive to mending fences for however they got soured, and I know AJ has also done the same thing, so it looks like we're going in the right direction. And really, it's truly, as Don pointed out, and as AJ has pointed out to Don,
It's not for the people that are sitting on the seat now. It's for when we're not here. Where's the condition of the school district in the city of Dacono 10, 15, 20 years from now? And that's what we'd like to do. That way when we do, when we're all not here, we can at least say, okay, the trains are on the tracks. So, sorry to interrupt, AJ.
You said you scheduled them already?
Yeah. Okay. It's him and his planner meeting with me and Jennifer.
Oh, not
yeah.
Okay.
No, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So, yeah, so that's how, you know, we like to typically do that counterpart to counterpart, and then like we talked about, have the board president come over or have, you know, an informal meeting with the board, so you guys can all get to know the board. And hopefully next time Don comes back to ask us for some support, it's for a school in Dacono.
We feel better about it.
And then they, I'll forward this. The same school district has doing Democracy Day that everyone wants to volunteer to help with or participate in. I'll have that information for you as well.
Nice. What else?
You need one more to make 10.
Next council meeting is the next council meeting.
There you go. Good job, AJ. Any other reports from staff, clerk, city, fire, police, council?
I'd like to thank you for coming to the Habitat Coalition that was last week to see what we're doing. I'd like to see more people come. Joe attended, and we had a pretty good turnout, about 30 of us. So it was getting all the ideas together and seeing what 2019 is going to present. So for that whole, for all the people taking place, it's interesting.
Kathy, that training that was sent around, what is it? That one that's in February that was sent, if we're interested, that they're going to present, you know, that the Habitat, some guy was going to present. Yeah, but what is the actual training?
The library?
I mean, what would we learn?
I think it was the, it's an asset-based. How the towns can use an asset-based process for obtaining, not necessarily a specific town, for even neighborhoods that can do that.
And is that what they're doing in Dacono?
That's what they're trying to gear it towards, being an asset-based. You know, the more assets, whether it's a personal gift that people have.
Oh, I see.
Okay. Some might be good with sales. Some might be good with their hands. Some might be good with design, some might be good as a painter, whatever, you know, it's the assets that each individual may hold.
Okay.
That's a lot of it. So.
Do they have a list of tasks that are needed, or do they need painters, do they need plumbers, do they need...
No, basically, because I looked at the volunteer one time, and that's, I didn't have the time, but it didn't specifically give me, like, what you could go and do. You know, if you have your own power tools or whatever else you wanted to do. Things like that. It didn't give me that, but I think they'll just call you. I'm not sure, to be honest.
You just give them your name and they'll.
Yeah.
They'll definitely put you to work.
Have the time to go and help and do those things. Yeah.
They'll take you and put you to work if you show up. They don't care whether it's building a house
a
or cleaning. If you're a plumber, they'll
right, yeah,
sweeping a floor. I carried wood.
Sweeping the floor.
So. Right.
Yeah.
Volunteering. So yeah.
What else, council?
I will be out of the country next meeting, so...
Where are you going?
I'm going to Costa Rica.
Really?
Nice.
Been there before?
Yes, my daughter lives there.
Oh, nice. Oh. Have a good time.
I'm going for my big birthday.
Yay.
For your what?
For a big birthday.
Happy B-Day. I won't ask.
Yeah.
A big one.
So, can you pay the chief of police a couple of compliments? I ran into a few people that... a couple state troopers that come to the dealership and do work with us and... had nothing but good things to say about the officers when they deal with them on the city and the interstates, and you know, just thought it was really cool. Had a command sergeant or command captain, excuse me, from Wyoming, paid big compliments to one of our officers that are here with us, been here for about 4 years, but was up there for many years and said, you know, miss the guy. You have a great officer in your hand, which just made detective, so kind of cool hearing that. So thank you for everyone attending the Christmas party. Had a great time. I got very dizzy a couple times. Man, those machines will just beat you up if you sit on them long enough, right? I think everybody did, though. What a great time. Looks like we're going to have to do a bigger venue next time. So, not to end on a sour note, but everybody knows that Mayor Carlson passed away. If they didn't, he passed away a little while ago. I guess I'm upset, and I shouldn't say this, but I'm upset the way we found out, because I would have liked to have found out sooner. But Wade served the city for 3 terms. He was a good mayor. He definitely let you know where he stood, no matter what it was. He wasn't afraid of telling you how he felt. Anybody that served with him, I served underneath of him. I think Kevin served underneath of him. He also encouraged a lot of people and tried to mentor a few people as he went along. His politics were passionate, and his service to Dacono was unwavering. And it's also a service to the country. So I asked AJ to lower the flag to half staff. I wanted to get through President Bush's ordeal through December. So I waited till this time, and I asked if the city was okay if I lowered the flag to half staff for the rest of the week for Wade, just paying respect to the man. He served the Navy, served it well. He bragged about that and also was very proud about that. If you got him to talk about his Navy service, he did the country very well. And like I said, I don't think that there's ever been a non-spirited discussion with Wade. He can get real cantankerous on you, but he's definitely convincing, I'll say that. So I'm sure everyone that served with him will say something good about him. So that's my rant. I already put you on the spot, so.
I said what I already said.
They did a nice article in the news about him, too, so it came out, and I think everyone read it, so I kind of put Kevin on the spot, but that's, you know, I think everyone felt the same way about the guy. So.
Yeah, he was outstanding.
Yeah. With that, we'll look for a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Motion by Robin, second by Kathy. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
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 No opposed.